What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm gonna show you some tips and tricks for using decals in Twinmotion to make your renders more interesting and realistic. Let's get started. So what are decals? Decals are basically 2D objects that you can overlay on top of your models to make the scene more interesting and realistic. In the Twinmotion library, there are several types of decals that you can use, such as decals for roads, imperfection decals, arc decals, object decals, signs, etc. Let's add some decals to the scene. Decals are super useful for creating roads. For example, in this area I have a crosswalk, so I can use the zebra crossing decal. I want it to be bigger, so I can increase the size here. Now to duplicate a decal, I can hold shift and move it in one direction like so. Here you can choose whether to create an instance or a copy. The difference between instances and copies is that when you are adjusting the opacity and offset of one decal, it will be affected if it's an instance, while the copy will not be affected. That looks good. Before I continue adding more decals, I will use the Asset Manager and create a new container, then move my decals in there. This will be useful later. Now I will add a parallel parking spot, then rotate it, and duplicate it. Note that you can type in a specific distance here as well. You can also increase the number of copies here to make an array of the same object. You can see that the decals add up quick. That's why it's a good idea to organize them in the Asset Manager. This is very useful because you can move the whole group and create copies easily. This is great for working with multiple decals. Now I can rotate and position it to fit the other side. There we go. Now I can repeat this process to add a line marking on the road, then make copies. And put them in a separate container. Then make more copies of that group. When working with roads, you can use real-world references like I'm doing here. This way, you can know how to create realistic roads. When sizing a decal, you can also stretch it along the width or height, but make sure you don't stretch it too much that it looks distorted. I will also add more markings, such as the left turn arrow for the left lane, and a straight and right turn arrow for the other lane. I will add some bicycle lane markings too. The cool thing is that you can save a group of decals as an asset to your user library. This way, you can easily use it for other projects later. You can also create a new folder specifically for decals like so. There we go, now just repeat this process anywhere you want to add decals. This intersection is looking pretty good. There are other objects that you can add as well, such as a manhole. The cool thing is that you can always replace objects without starting from scratch. Just select the objects that you want to replace, then right-click, Replace Object. Now you can choose an object in the library and click here to replace. Let's talk about the next tip. You can add more realism to your scene by using imperfection decals. For example, I can use sustain decals to add to the road. They also work on walls too. And it works on imported objects such as this car here. Pretty cool, huh? When adding decals to a wall, pay attention to the corners because it might wrap around like this. You can adjust the offset value to fix it. When using decals for imperfections, make sure you don't make it look repetitive. If there are similar decals, then you can mix them together to make the object look more unique. When working with multiple decals, make sure you stack them correctly by using the sort order. The higher the sort order number means that the decal will be on top. The lower the sort number order will place the decal at the bottom. You can experiment with the sort order and the opacity to get different effects when stacking decals. The decals in Twin Motions are really high quality. If you change the lighting of the scene, you can see that the decal reacts differently depending on the lighting, giving it a lot of depth, making it more realistic. When adding puddles, to get a better reflection, you can add a reflection puff above the puddle, then increase the size as you need. As you can see, this makes the reflection a lot more realistic. You can also play with the opacity to get different looks. In this case, I would set it as 98% to make it reflective but still keep the details from the ground below. There are also side decals that you can use, such as no smoking sign, bathroom sign, no pet signs, etc. There are also object decals, such as a door foam panel. This specific one is more appropriate for apartments, but you get the point. There are also air vents, which are great for interior. With this decal, you don't need to spend time to model the air vents, and they actually look pretty realistic. There are leaf decals as well, which are useful for the side of the road like this. Art decals are really good for creating graffiti on walls, especially textured walls like this brick wall here. But they also work on the ground. There are special ones that are used specifically for the ground like this one, which is also used in one of the poses for the animated kids characters. When adding a decal on a curved surface, you can increase the offset to make it look correct. If you have custom images, you can load them in the texture slot to create a custom decal. Just make sure your image is a PNG. Once you have imported it, you can rename it in the Asset Manager and add it to the user library. For higher quality decals, you can use Mega Scans. If you don't have credits, then click on the free section and go to Decals and try one of these. To make it work in Twin Motion, we need to turn this into a PNG. First, open the Albedo map in Photoshop, then import the Opacity map. Then I will hide it and add a layer mask to the Albedo map. Then go back to the Opacity map and press Ctrl A to select all, then Ctrl C to copy. Now you can turn off the Opacity map and hold down Alt, then left click the layer mask to open it. Then press Ctrl V to paste the Opacity map here. There we go. Now we can save this as a PNG. To load it in, just select a similar decal and replace the texture map. Then we can save it to our user library. Just repeat this process to create more custom decals. Note that right now the custom decals are quite limited, because we can't use the normal and roughness map for it, so the decals look flat. But maybe this is something Twinmotion will improve even more in the future. Anyway, those are some tips and tricks for using decals in Twinmotion to make your renders more interesting and realistic. If you want to get Twinmotion 2020, then follow this link here. That's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below and let me know if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.